Chicago is a huge tourist destination with some of the busiest airports in the country.
That is why the Aviation Institute of Maintenance is going above and beyond to train the technicians who are trusted to keep flying safe. And that dedication goes past enrollment with career services to help land graduates their dream jobs. Isaac, John, and Blake join us with more. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having us.
So, Isaac, I didn't even know this program existed in Chicago. And this is such a cool thing. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Absolutely. At the Aviation Institute of Maintenance, we offer Aviation Maintenance Technician Program, which is a 21-month program, so only 21 months, over 17 courses. In there, you learn a lot of great things, such as reciprocating engines, work with magnetos, and also safety wiring.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And John, not only are you a graduate from the past, but you're also now the director of education.
That is correct. Yes,
wow.
I am.
Okay.
Yes.
So you understand both sides of this program.
I do. Yeah.
Yeah. What makes it so outstanding, you think?
It's a short program. You know, 21 months, and the students, through the course of it, they will get their AMP license, their airframe and power plant certification. And during the program, they work on many different things, such as like what I'm holding here. This is actually a piece of honeycomb structure.
Okay.
You got fiberglass on one side, which is this side here, and then carbon fiber here. And this is basically what you walk on the aircraft.
So. Oh.
And you had us feel it earlier. It's so light, but that's what you're really looking for, something light so that you can hold, I'm assuming, more people, more equipment on the plane, more fuel.
Correct. Yeah.
Now, Blake, you are currently in the program, about to graduate. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Tell us about your story. What made you kind of drawn to this program, where you're at in your life, and kind of what took you this direction?
So I grew up with aviation in the family. Mm-hmm. I had a cousin who was an AMT with American Airlines for over 30 years. Kind of put me on the path, and I just kind of needed a change in my pace going forward.
Yeah.
So it really has been a life-changing experience. Going forward, it's going to be great.
Now, are you waiting until graduation? You said you still have one more test to go through.
Yeah.
Or do you already have something lined up in terms of work?
Interview processes are going on.
Uh-huh.
I kind of can't really talk about.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
No worries. Maybe something in
understand.
But
understand.
I think that's part of the program is that you guys then help with the job location and that kind of thing too.
Absolutely, absolutely. We have a career service program and department that they will meet with, and they will go through like mock interviews, build up their resumes. The great thing is that my career service coordinator builds relationships with different organizations and aviation companies out there. So when we match them with the aviation companies, which is a lot of fun. And I'm excited about his future. He's going to have a great one.
Oh, that's
love that. And then, John, what else did you bring with us here for show and tell? Because you showed us what the floor of the plane is made of, that incredibly light honeycomb material. But what's on the table here?
So on the table, we have an example of the I-beam that they make in their sheet metal class. It's riveting. They put some aluminum pieces together, rivet it, and then... on the board here, this is actually a electronic mock-up. So what they do is in one of the classes, they'll actually build this board. It'd be a blank slate, basically. And they have to put the switches in, the circuit breakers, build the wiring harnesses, all that stuff. And then once they get it all together, they actually hook it up to some power and see if everything works properly.
This is so great. So John and Blake, when you're in a plane, you know how the plane's staying in the air.
Exactly,
It's not some sort of magic, like when we're flying, how all this happens. You understand.
There's actually a running joke, flying is magic. That's how aircraft fly.
Yeah, exactly.
It is. So today is actually National Aviation Day as well. Do you guys throw a big bash, or what happens for people in the industry?
Well, actually, we had an aviation day at our campus.
You did?
Yes, we had, it was led by Aerostar, which is Dr. Tamara Holmes' organization.
Uh-huh.
We also partner with Boeing, but we invited Chicago Public School students there, as well as Gary, Indiana Public School students there. There's over 100 students there that we took through different activities, different learning aspects of aviation. It was a lot of fun.
Incredible. That's my awesome. Goodness. Yes. All right. Well, we're just glad you're turning out these aviation technicians, because we need them,
Absolutely.
Because every time we fly, there's some sort of delay, maintenance delay. So there's clearly a need there. Thank
now
you
know people you can call.
Yeah. And what's happening? Thank you so much for being with us. Thanks to Isaac, John, and Blake. For more information, just head to aviationmaintenance.edu.